I'm Jermaine from PCMag.com, and here I've got the Steam controller from Valve. Now, Valve, as you may know, has previously just made games and the Steam marketplace, but now they're getting into making physical hardware because they're trying to bring the PC gaming experience to the living room. And part of that strategy is with this new Steam controller. So let's open it up and see what they came up with. Now, the Steam controller has gone through a lot of revisions since they announced it a few years ago. Initially, it was just these two large touch surfaces, but the final product looks a lot more like a traditional gaming controller. You have your four face buttons, A, B, X, Y, an analog stick, four triggers on the back, and something that looks like a D-pad. But these two touch surfaces do offer things that previous controllers could not. It offers a lot of PC gaming needs a mouse. It needs that kind of precision. And this touch surface, while not quite as precise as that, offers something that's a lot closer than I was expecting. I got to test it out when I visited Valve a few days ago. They had it demoing with Just Cause 3, which is an upcoming console game. But with this, it's kind of the best of both worlds. You have your stick and your face buttons like you want. But with this touch surface, you can aim very precisely, like as if you're using a mouse. Now, since Valve wants Steam machines to be able to play a wide variety of PC games, they're letting you be very—they're letting users customize how they can bind buttons on the Steam controller. So they also demoed System Shock 2, which is kind of an older game that was just on like keyboard and mouse. So what they showed off, different community members can suggest different like button layouts. So say you want to have a certain command on the touchpad or a certain command on the buttons or the stick, you can pick that all out. And you can kind of read what other people are doing to see, you know, maybe this is the best way to play this particular game versus a different layout for a different game. You can also see here this D-pad etching on the left side. Now, when I talked to Valve, they initially wanted to get rid of the D-pad altogether. They thought it was kind of an old, kind of archaic input. But what they found was that people really missed it, that it's that people like having these four cardinal directions. And so they kind of split the difference. This surface is a touch surface, but you can click in on the D-pad and get that as well. I can't feel it now, but if I was actually playing a game, I could also feel that these surfaces kind of offer haptic feedback, which feels pretty good. They demoed it with like entering text. You can have two cursors on screen at once. You're kind of going like this, and you can feel where the mouse goes from each key. So setting up the Steam controller is simple. It's like using any other third-party PC controller. They have this little included USB dongle. You just plug it into any computer that runs Steam, which is a lot of them at this point. So yeah, that's the Steam controller. It's going to be available for $59.99. If you pre-ordered it, it should be coming out soon, and if not, it'll start arriving on store shelves around November, early November. So that's the Steam controller.